Watching a wild animal quenching its thirst from a murky pond or a stagnant lake might raise concerns about the water's cleanliness. After all, drinking such visibly dirty water seems like a health risk for these animals. However, wild beasts not only survive, but thrive by consuming water from natural sources that humans would typically avoid. How do these animals manage to stay hydrated without becoming ill? For humans, consuming contaminated water can lead to severe illnesses, and in some cases, even death. We are cautious about sources that might be filled with bacteria, viruses, and parasites. In the wild, though, animals don't have the luxury of being choosy about their drinking sources. Critically, many species develop a tolerance for harmful microorganisms found in their local water sources due to repeated exposure. Drinking from the same ponds regularly exposes their immune systems to the same pathogens. As a result, their bodies learn to identify and effectively respond to these specific germs. This acquired resistance is not foolproof. Significant changes in water quality can still make wildlife sick. However, on a day-to-day basis, their defenses adjust to the familiar array of microorganisms present in their native water sources. What might seem like ongoing low-level exposure actually functions as a form of inoculation rather than leading to illness. Of course, not all natural water bodies are breeding grounds for contagion. Some pristine streams and lakes exist with minimal biological contamination. Contrary to appearances, many wilderness water sources contain fewer microorganisms than one might anticipate. Furthermore, most waterborne pathogens aren't necessarily lethal, especially to animals adapted to their presence. What might cause a wild deer some mild stomach discomfort could prove fatal to an unaccustomed human. The severity of illness depends on the specific microorganism and the host it infects. Over time, natural selection refines this resistance. Animals that can tolerate dirtier water pass down advantageous genetic traits to their offspring. Consequently, successive generations become even more resilient to the challenges posed by their local environment. However, it's important not to assume that wildlife never suffer from waterborne illnesses. Outbreaks absolutely occur, especially when areas undergo sudden changes. Additionally, sick animals tend to withdraw and hide, making it rare for researchers to directly witness the effects of these illnesses. In essence, animals endure the kind of exposure that humans would instinctively avoid through a combination of physiology, behavior, and evolutionary adaptation. However, we don't need to envy their adaptability. As modern humans, we possess the privilege of purifying water before consumption. Our technologies spare us from the continuous risks that wildlife confront every day. Modern humans live with an unprecedented degree of insulation from the unpredictable forces of nature. Our heating, plumbing, medical advancements, and food systems shield us from the harshest elements of life on this planet. This detachment from nature might lead us to underestimate the resilience required for survival in the wild. Thriving in the wilderness necessitates a level of tenacity that can be challenging for us to fathom. From weather fluctuations and nutritional availability to exposure to microorganisms, animals are forced to adapt to the array of challenges in their environment or fail to survive. Their secret lies in their deep attunement to local rhythms, a quality honed over countless generations. This deep connection to a specific place imparts vital lessons from which humans could learn. Our transient mobility often fosters a disconnect from any particular locale. But true wisdom and resilience emerge when lives are intertwined with a single landscape over time. All living creatures share in the interconnectedness of the water on this planet. May its continuous flow serve as a reminder of the Earth's enduring nature, which needs no monuments, but rather an unwavering commitment and respect for her perennial changes.